folks, welcome back. My name is Ben, and today we're back playing some more Pneumatic Crafts, and we're going to have some fun today. We're going to learn a little bit more about some of the power generation stuff for this mod, take a look at maybe some programming stuff for some drones that I did, and we're going to learn why I'm not using the drones right now, and then I'll get into some redstone-y stuff maybe later on in the episode. So let's talk about what we're doing today. Last time we left off, we had these drones about. I think I have one in here. Yeah, we had these drones here, and I did a little bit of drone programming. I think I did this off camera, if I remember right. And basically, I have this guy here. He's an attack drone. He's got this entity attack here, and this drone starts out, imports items from over here, goes and grabs a sword. And he uses that sword to attack things in an area that was way over, kind of in front of me, way over there. So that was fine, you know, it was working out okay. But the thing about this entity attack right here is that it takes 200 milliliters a hit. And when you got about two or three hits per mob to drop them, they can get a little expensive. And I was running out of power really quick. This guy would basically come over, he would, fill up on his air pressure, and then that would almost, drain me dry, basically, after he would do that maybe three or four times. And, basically what happens is, you know, once my air pressure got down that low, my whole base basically stopped working. The elevator stopped working, the pressure chamber stopped working, almost everything stopped working. So I was at a loss for a while. I was actually running up the sides of the helix to get up here to do my work to get this thing back going. So my plan was, well, we gotta upgrade our power. We gotta find a constant source of power. So I was looking at some of the different power generation options here in the built-in wiki. If you don't have this is another mod that the mod author wrote. The in-game wiki. It can be made for other mods, but it's kind of right now. I think it's Pneumatic Crafts specific. But under power generation, we had a couple different options, I guess, to generate pressure. So you've got the air compressor and you've got the liquid compressor. The air compressor, kind of know that's just our thing. You throw some charcoal in there, it generates air pressure, no big deal. But generating charcoal kind of on the fly, one, it was boring. I've done it a million times. I've been in all my Pneumatic Craft playthroughs, and I've been doing that for a while, so I kind of thought I wanted to do something a little different. So I started looking at this liquid compressor. This is pretty easy to make. It's just an air compressor and some plastic and a bucket, no big deal. And thing with this air compressor, or the liquid compressor, let's see if I have one lying about, no I don't, is that they can take a variety of liquids and turn them into power, and they make power at a pretty good clip. Let me see if I can go back into that. Generating pressure, liquid compressor, and yeah, you have to look at the thing to find out what kind of liquids. It can take a lot of liquids. A lot of liquids actually that come from Tinker's Construct, all the molten metals. You can actually take liquid plastic and you can make power from that. Not at a very good rate though. A lot of the molten metals and a lot of the other stuff that comes from Tinker's Construct makes power at a pretty good clip. The only problem was finding something that would make helmet's almost out of here. The problem was finding something I could get at a consistent rate. And so I thought I would show you a little bit of that in a creative world before I show you what I ended up doing here. So you know what, let's go ahead and jump over to the creative world and I'll show you a little bit what I got going on. I'll meet you over there. Okay folks, we're back and we are looking here. This is the liquid compressor that I was talking about before. And if you go into the interface for this, you can kind of get an idea of some of the available fuels in this little tab right here. And I was saying before, a lot of the molten metals do a nice job. You can see you can get all these different liquid metal, molten electrum, liquefied emerald, blah, blah, blah. And they can go into molten iron and blood. That's interesting. Liquid plastic is 5, but here's kind of the rate that they make liters per bucket. So these ones give you 40, and like plastic gives you 5. That's not a lot. So I thought about these and looking at a lot of these things, and I can't really get seared stone you get from cobblestone. If I had a good cobblestone generator, that might be an option. But then to get seared stone, you kind of need you need to break that down with lava, so that's not really the best. So the idea that I had is to use blood. Blood you can get from your smeltery by simply, here you go, let's do this, type set 0, and let's change this back to hard. You can get blood from the smeltery basically just by throwing a mob in there. As those mobs sit in that, they'll start taking damage. And as they sit in there long enough, I think each time they take damage from it, get a little more blood. Yep. So you start getting a good amount of blood going in here once you've had enough mobs. I think you get about 100 or so blood per mob, which is pretty good, I think. But anyways, so I was thinking, you know, I could hook that mob farm up to this thing, and then just kind of pour blood into this, which is kind of morbid. You can see I've got about 5 buckets of blood in this thing. Gross. But anyways, and I can use that to generate power. Well, how can I then regulate that somehow where I'm not just pouring blood into this thing all the time and losing pressure? You can add the security grade upgrade, and that'll stop this thing from going into the red and possibly exploding. But you don't want it to waste blood either. You don't just want it to run constantly and basically just waste the blood up. You want this thing to turn off, which you can, which is really cool. So you can change this thing to enable on a low or high signal. Right now I have it set to low, and I'll show you why in a second. So what I ended up doing is installing a pressure gauge tube module, and these are little, there's little tube modules you can make. I can show you some tubes and modules, and these things are made just with various different recipes. There's a safety tube that will release pressure when it gets too high. There's a regulator tube that stops pressure from going through the tube. There's our pressure gauge that we want to use. There's one that detects how much pressure is going through the thing. There's a grate that blows things away or sucks stuff in, and there's a charging module too, which is pretty cool. Get out of here, you. Get out of here. No one wants you around. Slimes. I got slimes all over, slime plants all over the place. That's great. So yeah, you know, let's just set it back to peaceful. So now this thing's bothering us. So what you can do, these things will emit a redstone signal, basically based off of how much pressure is in the thing, but you can actually change that by applying a thing called an advanced PCB. And these are made, see if I can show you that real quick. How can I bring up, there we go, NEI. Let's see, what are they made? Yeah, here we go. There we are. So you need a printed circuit board, and you need some of that yellow plastic. That's what we got from the helium plants, and some redstone. And then I guess that's just unassembled PCBs and transistors, capacitors, all that stuff. So that's good. So you can kind of slap that thing in there, like so. And then after you right-click it again, you'll get this pressure gauge tube module. Oh, I had a hard time saying that. So basically what you have here is you have a low end and you have a higher end. And the lower end is on the low and the higher end is on the high. You kind of get this little line here going from the low to the high. And basically that is set. So basically what happens is this thing will not emit a redstone signal until it gets over 4.5 bars. That's what kind of the 4.7 kind of represents, that as soon as this thing gets over that, it starts emitting a redstone signal. That's what's going on right here. So we have that redstone signal being picked up by this repeater. Okay, so let's start following the redstone. So the repeater goes to this line of redstone here, connects to this repeater, and that's applying a redstone signal to the compressor. And since that's set to low, it turns it off, right? So great. So it's not running, it's not making pressure, and that's what we want. Then we have it going over to here, and then it's connected to that repeater, which is turning off that redstone torch. So why is it turning off that redstone torch? Well, we have a little circuit over here. And I can kind of show you this. If you haven't seen a let's get a comparator. And this is kind of a really simple clock that you can make. Comparators, when you turn them into this mode, this is called, I think the message, a subtractor. When it's in subtraction mode, it essentially will take the signal from right here, and the signal, I believe, that it gets from over here. And whenever that signal, basically this signal minus that signal, you can see it kind of goes from, it goes to 2, and then it's hard to explain how it exactly works, but essentially when it hits 13 there, it goes to, I think 13 minus 15 is, you know, it would be negative 2, but since it's actually, you know, negative, I think it goes to 0, that turns it off. And then as soon as it goes off, it could, you know, this is still emitting a 15, so it gets turned back on. So I don't know if that makes sense or not, but it makes sense to me at least. So that essentially gives you a nice little clock that you can mess around with. You can use a, say like a repeater to kind of lengthen that if you want. So you get like a slower clock. But that's kind of a pretty easy clock, and you can, if you want to turn it off, you just remove the torch, or you can remove the redstone signal, whatever you want to do. So that's essentially what I'm doing right here, is that I have a, this torch is turned off right now, so this clock isn't running. If it was on, this block would get powered, and that block in turn turns on the seared faucet, pours some blood into this thing, right? Okay, cool. It also would send that signal over here to that, to this repeater. The repeater would power this block. That block would in turn power this redstone, and then over back to this repeater, which are both set onto the 4-tick delay, and then back to the comparator. The comparator would turn it off, and the redstone torch would turn it back on again. So we can kind of see this in proof, I guess, by essentially what I do is I take a drone, and let's get a drone back. Just an empty drone, any drone will do. Oh, not that guy. This one, the empty ones. So we'll take this drone and we'll put him in here, and he will dump all his pressure out. Now, since the pressure has dropped down to 1.7 bars, this signal gets turned off. You can see the pressure gauge is emitting redstone of 0, or false, essentially. So this is not turned on. So the liquid compressor can run. You can see it's using a little bit of blood. It's actually getting filled up with blood too. And we'll see that a little bit more in my live world, where I have this tested out a little bit more. But the torch is on, so this clock is running. And every time this runs, you see a little bit of blood gets put in there. And off we go. So this will fill up with blood, as long as there's blood in there. And you know, I just give it some zombie pigment here in creative mode every once in a while. In the live world, oh, we're in peaceful. Gotta change that back. So that's why I'm kind of, that's why I've connected this to the mob farm that I built in my survival world. So let's go over there and we'll see this in action, and you can kind of see what's going on. All right, meet you back. Okay, folks, we're back, and we're over here. We're on the edge of our of the helix right here, and we're going off to where the power generation happens. I had to build this thing out a little ways. If you're too close to this mob farm, mobs actually don't spawn, but they will spawn if you're basically inside of here. Basically, it's like, I think it's a 24 to 32 block radius is where they'll actually start spawning. So you can kind of see down on the mini-map. I can bring that up. Can I do this? Nope. What is it? This one. Oh, it doesn't show up on this map. Well, if you look down in the bottom right corner, you can see right in front of me there's some mob faces. If we run over here, we can kind of might be able to see one. Yeah, but eventually we'll see one. So basically what's happening is this is just a standard kind of mob farm. Oh, I think we got one. You in there? Oh, yeah, he's in there. So Mr. Creeper is just going to stand there and die. Yep. Great. And that in turn gets us some blood. We got a lot of blood going on. We'll chat about that in a minute. But this is just a standard mob farm. I've used this design in a lot of my builds. It's basically just a... it's a mob farm that Etho designed. I don't know if any of you guys watch his videos, but he does some good stuff. But I can just... I'll crack this open just a minute. Yeah, but there's basically just this. All these spawning pads are 2 high and then a 3x3, and that just prevents spiders from spawning. You don't want spiders because they won't fall into these little water streams. Other mobs will because it's only 2 high. They'll jump into the water and just get swept away into the middle, which is what we want. Oh, we have a zombie in my base. Yeah, something's not lit up. Keep an eye out for that. So yeah, they just get swept into the middle here, and yeah, that's how we're generating our mobs. Okay, so let me hop out of here and put this. I really like these French tiles; they look nice. French cobblestone look good, right? Yeah. Look at that zombie! What a jerk! Like you're gonna do anything? He's what a guy. Okay. Anyways, so the zombies fall into our smeltery here. They burn up into blood. You see, we're using a little. No, we're probably not using any right now, actually. Yeah. See, this has turned on. Oh, we are using a tiny, tiny bit. And you can kind of see that here. See, it just ticks down a little bit. Just very, very little right now is what we're using. And basically, we're just filling up the pressure chamber, I think. It's the only thing left that really needs a good amount of pressure. But you can kind of even watch it from here. If we turn on the pressure here, you can kind of see this never really gets below, or it never goes over 275,000. It kind of sits there. And yeah. You can kind of see it there. And then we're using just the tiniest amount of blood. You see, you can't even, it doesn't even show the animation for it here, but it does pour it out, you know, as we can attest to right there. Yeah, just ever so slowly. And that doesn't use any fuel. You'll never need any lava for it. The mobs will just continuously fall in. There is just a bit of molten iron in here. But this thing is full, and this thing is using it at such a slow rate, I don't think we'll have to worry about this too much. And we'll be doing all our work in here, so we'll be generating mobs anyways. So we should be getting more and more blood just passively, which is nice. And yeah, we just have the same circuit all set up here. I think I could even, if I need to later, these casting channels, again from Tinker's Construct, you can actually connect them like pipes. They basically are liquid pipes, essentially. So I think I could even connect, you know, another one of these liquid compressors to this. And, you know, like right now, I still have 15 buckets of blood. This one has 16 buckets in it. So, you know, if I ever got, you know, more and more, if I had, you know, a ridiculous amount of blood, I think I could power maybe 2 or 3 of these things off of this. You know, so I think it's a good, power gen, at least. It's one I don't think I'm going to have to worry about too much. Yeah, like I said, the only thing I think that we're waiting on to stop filling up is the pressure chamber, and just because that takes so much. Yeah, see, this is at 4.5. Oh, it's still just filling up with air, and that's fine. So your whole, you know, you have to remember all, there's pipes going all the way out there and then up and, you know, all around. So see, here's my little highway of pipes going out to the mob farm. I do kind of plan on collecting the drops. I thought this would work, but it's not working. So I had a chest over here. It works sometimes, but not very reliably. I think I'll end up putting a train over there, or not a train, a hopper minecart, just to pick up all the drops, and you know, so I can have stuff. But yeah, that is how we are generating power that will allow us to get back into trying out the drones and using all of those guys and seeing what they're up to. Yeah, I can see I got a little bit of stuff from the hoppers. I don't know. It's definitely not everything. I think if I were to run around this thing, maybe not. Usually I pick up a few items just by running around it. But yeah, so I've gotten some stuff. I'll be getting some more. Yeah, liquid compressor, you're working great. And there's an advanced liquid compressor here that is, you know, pretty easy to make. It takes these advanced pressure tubes, which really aren't too bad to make. Those things aren't too bad to make. But the advanced one, let's see if I can show that one. I think it generates power at a faster rate. It can produce compressed air. It's an upgraded version of the compressor. Generates 50 milliliters per tick and can resist up to 20 bars. So that's pretty quick. Maybe upgraded with speed upgrades, blah, blah, blah. But it needs to be cooled. Ooh, that's something we haven't gotten into yet. It adds, Pneumaticraft also has a heat system, I guess. And you actually have to put like ice and other things. It actually keeps track of things that are hot and cold, which is kind of cool. So something we'll have to worry about maybe later on. I don't know what's really going to take 20 bars of pressure to mess with. That seems like a ton right now. Like, 5 bars right now for me is plenty to even keep up with. So, yeah, I don't know what 20 bars is going to require, but we might actually have to make that, like, an addition off of this, just to kind of create a separate network. I did put an advanced pressure tube right here. Just because I've seen sometimes the tube coming out of the compressor gets a little too much power, and I've seen these explode. I think Etho had a video where this kept exploding on him. So you replace it with advanced pressure tube. So I thought, why not? Might as well save myself a lot of grief and from causing the thing to explode. But this thing has kept it at right at 4.5, which is right where I want it. See, I've got the same setup I had in the creative world, and it's, you know, same circuit, all that stuff. So yeah, that is how we're generating power, and I'm really happy with it. I really like it, even though it's morbid. It's funny. I always end up doing something pretty evil in all my videos, or in all my series, and I guess this will be our one morbid thing from this series, is that we're gonna generate power from blood. We're gonna run our base off the blood of our enemies. Alright guys, well I think that's gonna be my video for today. This might be my last video for a little while. I've mentioned in my other videos, my wife is, she is now 37 and a half weeks pregnant. We're expecting the little one along any time. So I'm probably not gonna get a lot of time to record. I did have a little time to play and a little time to record, so I thought I might as well show this to you guys and show off a little bit of my base. I got this little thing set up. And I do have one other thing to show you. But yeah, I probably won't have a lot of time to record, so this might be my last one for a little while at least. So just keep that in mind if you're looking for another episode from me. Probably won't be coming for a little while. This is where I actually was trying to generate power before. And what this is... ta-da! Zombie Pigman Farm. And but you know, it just wasn't generating... I actually had the smeltery set up right here instead of this little thing with spruce logs and clear glass. But it wasn't generating pigmen fast enough. And if you can kind of see on the mini-map right now, there's a lot of mobs over in the mob farm, even right now. So this, yeah, that thing runs a lot quicker than this thing ever will. Also, I guess got an obscene amount of obsidian, which I didn't really feel like doing. But we are getting a little bit of gold and some rotten flesh, so that's fine, you know. I'm happy with that, you know. We do need a little bit of gold for this mob, so I'm pretty happy with that. We did get another smeltery set up over here, and we are generating some. That's where we're doing all our stuff here. I've got, a single. It got stuck. That's fine. No big deal. I'll worry about that later. But I think that's going to be our episode for today, guys. Hope you like how I'm generating power. Hope you like how the pneumatic craft stuff is going. I think in the next video, I hope to get into some drones a little more. I do have some ideas of stuff I want to try. I do kind of want to try getting that automated tree farm going. I think that would be pretty cool to do. I'm just unsure of how to do it right now. Having the drones interact with the furnace is a little tricky. It doesn't seem to want to do exactly, you know, mess with each side of this furnace in the way that I thought it would. So, yeah. That's my one deterrent from doing a tree farm again. But again, I like how I'm generating power. I don't really need the charcoal. It's just kind of a want at this point. So, all right, I will stop rambling on. Hope you're enjoying the series on Pneumaticraft. I am really enjoying it. I think it's a really cool mod. Be sure to check it out if you haven't already. And I will see you guys in the next one. Have a great day. Take care. Have a good day. Bye-bye.